This book, I wrote the book really because my mother wasn't too good at cooking fish. Basically all these dishes are sort of stuff you can do at home, using local ingredients, fresh fish, simplified versions of what we do in the restaurant really. I was born in Hull, north of England, on the east coast in 1968. I became very interested in cooking when I was around 15 years of age. I left school, I went to work in an industrial canteen, paid myself to go to school one day a week, and after 2 years of washing dishes and going to school, I asked the chef in charge of the school, I want to cook. So he told me to lie to all the five-star hotels in Great Britain and send applications off so I could start a real apprenticeship. By the age of 23, I was head chef. Then we moved location and we won 3-star Michelin, where I was a head chef again. And basically after that, I moved to France and worked in a 3-star Michelin in France. The drive, the passion, the intensity was what's driven me throughout the whole of my career. Between Marco Pierre White and Michel Roux, they are the godfathers of food as I'm concerned, and I owe them everything I can do. My favorite Tasmanian food, it'd be probably the crayfish. Tasmanian rock lobsters are an amazing product. I'm fortunate enough to get them in Melbourne. They're featuring tonight on the menu. Because I'm from the north of England, I like beer. I like Tasmanian Cascade, or I like Bogues, or partners to the dinner and the series that we're doing over here is with Joseph Chamay, and basically his wine is amazing. Tasmanian wine and food are second to none throughout the world. My advice to the students, make sure you've read your recipes. Make sure you've dreamt about the recipes. Make sure you've dreamt again about the recipes, because at the end of the day, nobody really cares about how hard it is to produce it. They just remember how amazing it was to eat it. Keep going, you're on the right track. You're producing some amazing products. Last night, I was fortunate enough to try 4 Tasmanian whiskies, amazing whiskies, now becoming well renowned. 15 years ago, nobody knew about Tasmanian whiskey. Nobody really knew about Tasmanian wine. You've got an amazing culture happening here. You just need to keep going and keep going. And if you fail, get up again and keep going again.